was really interested in the concept of getting together with other teachers and with other parents and just talking a little bit more about how we could work better together. That was really, really useful exercise. I thought it's really good to actually put yourself in the other person's shoes and see things from their perspective. Gave me a new appreciation for where the teachers are at, and actually where my kids were at as well. That was probably an eye-opener. I'd never really considered them before. It was really beneficial in improving communication with the teachers and also with other parents. It gave me, you know, a nice introduction and involvement with some of the other parents that I didn't know. And it certainly made me appreciate more the teachers, and it gave us a better bond, and it's helped us share more of our own personal lives and what's going on in Henry's life with the teachers where it's relevant. I think that's been really great.
I gave them enough time to settle in for the day and made sure that they were really happy, and as well communicating with the teachers really opened my eyes to where they were at, and made me realise how important it was that I inform them about everything that's going on in my children's lives, you know, whether it's something in our family life or just generally what they were like in terms of behaviour, and really made me look more at working together with them and making sure that we were consistent. So what I was doing at home was what they were doing in the centre too, so that was useful.
I've tried to be less stressed out and panicked at drop-off time, and to take a little bit more time to keep teachers informed and up to date with what's going on, and also to hear what's been going on with Henry at school each day. I think as much as it's given me a better understanding of what issues they're facing every day, I think it's given them a better understanding of, from the perspective of a parent as well, and it's definitely built stronger relationships with them. To get involved, because it's wonderful to have the opportunity to have some input, and also to understand more about how the centre works and what the teachers are doing with your children each day. They're the most important things in our lives, our children, and it's really important that we've got that communication seamlessly between us so that we can benefit our kids.
Well, get involved, it's really beneficial, we get a lot out of it, and it will really, I think, enrich your child's experience of the childcare centre and also really help you feel more connected. Absolutely. No, I think it would be very beneficial. I think it's got a lot to offer, and it would be good for other centres to try it out. Absolutely.
Yes, definitely. I think every ECE centre would have different concerns, different areas that they need to improve, and I think they could all use this model to help them get through those issues and just build that stronger relationship between the parents and the teachers.
Absolutely. If our relationships with our parents are warm and trusting, then we're very likely to have the children back at the centre. So yes, it's very, very important. I think it's really important to have those one-to-one conversations, whether it's a parent coming in to drop the child off in the morning or picking up the child after work. It's really, really important to stay connected and to communicate. We always tell parents that they're welcome to contact us during the day to come in and visit their child, and it's wonderful. We've open door policy here, and we love it when our parents ring up or come and visit us. It's always a positive experience. One of the greatest barriers is that time. A lot of parents, they're really tired at the end of the day and will only give us a few moments to speak with us to catch up on what's happened for their child. But we do find that parents really enjoy hearing about their children's day. So even when we've had really shy parents, we've been able to sort of get them to talk and just spend a little time with us, and where we've tried to just share what's happened for their child at the end of the day. There's some parents that we aren't able to communicate with face-to-face at times because, you know, it's a real quick drop-off, or it's the other parent that's responsible for bringing the child and picking them up. But they will contact us through emails and some even on Facebook. I think some parents, especially Pacific parents, sometimes have that perspective or this the way of thinking that the teachers sort of know best, but no, it's not like that at all. Parents know their children much better than we do. We share a lot of the same emotions, the same challenges, and mainstream parents also face the same challenges that Pacific parents face, and it's really important that we try and get them to open up and to share the stories that they have of their child at home. And that's interesting, because when they do share, they find out a lot of things are actually being repeated for the child at school as well, and it's a great way for us to be able to share the interests of the child when we're sharing through our stories about, you know, what's happening for the child during the day. To go away with confidence, to be strong in their culture and their identity, to know who they are. But everybody's special, as one of our children, one of our little girls at school says, you know, everybody's special, and that's what we want them to leave this place knowing that they are special, and to leave this place with the confidence that they can be who they are and be proud of who they are. That we communicate, and that if we have questions to ask them, and that's both ways, and also to take time to maybe notice what's not being said, because sometimes it's our silences that are more powerful than what's been spoken. I can think of a particularly of a young mum who was very shy. I thought she was very shy, but when I got to know her, oh my goodness, she was just wonderful, and she was a lot more confident than I thought she was, and we were able to invite her to come in and share her language and culture with the children, and it was wonderful, and staff just loved having a parent come in and share, you know, their knowledge with us.
Wants to have a closer relationship with early childhood in New Zealand. That presents an opportunity for Plunket to engage with parents.
Partnering with parents isn't a parenting program in the traditional sense of the word. It's more about how the wider community, who all care for the same group of children, can work together more intentionally. It also explores conscious parenting, which is thinking about parenting. Looking at our own childhoods and reflecting on our own experiences helps us see what it is that we want for our children. Skip also provides a consistent parenting message throughout the whole of New Zealand, which I think is unique for our country.
It can also help with the key messages around raising healthy children. Regan spoke of the perspective of positive parenting, positive conscious parenting, but Plunket also advocates key messages around with health messages. I think that it's a natural combination of early childhood parents and health professionals together, because that reaches across the whole child. Mm-hmm.
I look at you.
Thank you very much.
That's the end of it.